Louise Wool from Hearts Unbroken and Cassidy Rainbergoff from Rain Is Not My Indian Name probably have the largest chunks of my personal experience integrated into their stories. And the girls are cousins. So they're essentially two sides of a coin, or perhaps a glimpse of inner children at slightly different ages and stages. Like Louise, I grew up predominantly in middle-class suburban Kansas. I was an avid student journalist, and I found myself often wrestling with my understanding of who I was and what that meant and the rest of the world. It was, especially I think growing up during the 80s when conformity was king, but still today, experience that was constantly riddled with what we now call microaggressions. You know, Kansas City Chiefs paraphernalia was everywhere. I remember walking through the high school and, you know, seeing sports posters that said things like scalp the Indians or this and that. I mean, it was all very heavy-handed, stereotypical work. While that is changing slowly, and Native kids today are still encountering all of that. At the same time, you know, I had friends, I had young romances. I was particularly close to my best friend, as so many kids in high school are, and she was a white girl, and we're still best friends today. And we had different experiences growing up. So I was thinking about all of those elements coming together, and I wanted to write a book that in some ways unpacked speech. Media speech, religious speech, interpersonal speech, political speech, all the different ways it manifests, and particularly with regard to artistic speech, the difference between the art and the artist, if there is one, and how we navigate it. What happens when speech goes wrong? And that can happen in any of those contexts. So I personalized it because I don't believe in writing characters who are too perfect. I think that flattens their humanity. I love flawed characters, and I particularly think that girl teen characters deserve the opportunity to be flawed and for that to be okay and for everyone to see and celebrate that on the page. So my character Louise sends the worst possible thing with what she considers the best possible intentions and then has to wrestle with impact and apology. All of that sounds like a very grown up analysis coming from an overeducated person. So I'll boil it down another way and say that the book started as a novel length apology to my high school boyfriend for having said the worst possible thing with what I thought were the best possible intentions, and the rest was history.